On the 26th of February 1935, the Daventry Experiment proved the ability of using radio waves to detect aircraft, heralding the development of radar. Welcome to History Pod. The idea of using radio waves to detect objects had begun to be explored from the early 1900s, but practical applications remained limited. In 1934, while tensions in Europe were increasing due to concerns about the threat of aerial bombardment, Scottish radio engineer Robert Watson Watt was asked by the Air Ministry to assess whether enemy aircraft could be destroyed using radio waves. Working with his colleague Arnold Wilkins, they concluded that it was impossible given the limitations of equipment at the time, but instead proposed using high-frequency radio signals to detect incoming aircraft. To test this concept, Watson Watt and Wilkins designed an experiment using a BBC shortwave radio transmitter located near Daventry in Northamptonshire. The transmitter was used to generate a continuous radio signal at 49.8 metres, that's approximately 6 megahertz, while a receiving station was set up in a field around 6 miles away that consisted of two receiving antennae attached to CRT monitoring equipment installed in a van. A Hadley Page Hayford bomber was then instructed to fly through the radio signal's path. As the aircraft moved, the signal it reflected caused detectable variations in the received radio waves displayed on the CRT. This confirmed that an aircraft could be identified based on its impact on radio signals, demonstrating the principle of radar. The government promptly invested in further radar development, and by the late 1930s, a radar network known as Chain Home had been constructed along the British coastline, and which played a critical role in detecting and intercepting enemy aircraft during the Second World War.